morning, Atlantis. Unlike Dorothy, you guys really do fly over the rainbow. All of us wish we could as well. You're off to see the Wizards of Mir today, and Rendezvous has some directions to the Yellow Brick Road.
Roger that. We're really glad to hear from you in Houston. We'll be interested in hearing from Rendezvous, and I think maybe Chris has got a tally-ho.
That's great news.
We are certainly inspired by the morning wake-up music, and I agree. I don't think we're going to Oz, but it's certainly a dream coming true.
Copy that, Ken, and tell Jerry that was an easy tune for us to pick for him today.
What's our range, Demir?
It's ticking down. Let me get the exact number. Atlantis, Houston, the number is 143 nautical miles.
Tally-ho.
Copy the tally-ho. Atlantis Rendezvous would like a handheld laser mark if you can provide one.
Okay, we show 134 miles.
That's within the error bars.
We've been looking at it with the binoculars, and actually we're quite impressed that we can still actually see the flashing lights, considering that most of that light has to be bounced from the sun. Those are pretty impressive flashers.
In our TV picture, we can still see the oscillation as well. That is impressive.
Atlantis, back with you on Tadris East, and we have a picture of Mir.
Roger that. Houston, Atlantis, tail gale, I'm happy. We have TCS 1 and 2 locked up. Correction, locked on the target.
Okay, we'll tell her.
The Mir space station is now in its equivalent of free drift, meaning the station is inhibited from having any movements during the final phases of the rendezvous and docking. Atlantis is now at 40 feet from the space station. Slowing the approach to station keep at a distance of about 30 feet before Commander Ken Cameron will initiate the final approach and docking. Atlantis, 35 feet now below the space station. Commander Ken Cameron will be slowing the descent or the initial response or rendezvous with the station. The rendezvous officer here in Mission Control in Houston are reporting the crew's about 1 minute away from initiating the final approach. Ten feet now from the docking.
Land is back with you, Tejas West.
Copy that.
Так, ребята, вы готовы?
Less than 2 minutes from docking, Atlantis is now 8 feet from the space station, closing at a rate of 0.07 feet per second.
Есть рабочий режим. ГСУ-1. Режим СЭП.
Сейчас 0.09 футов в секунду. Дальность 7.5 футов.
То бишь 2 метра примерно.
Да.
Понятно.
Five feet from docking. Four feet and less than 1 minute from docking.
2 фута, ребят.
Так, есть касание, есть индикаторный режим, есть сетка.
Contact, capture.
Capture confirmed.
Есть захват. Так, ну, касание прошло нормально. Давление станции 712 не изменилось.
Давление еще контролируем какое-то время.
Конечно, конечно.
Capture is confirmed. Atlantis is now docked with the Russian space station.
Понятно, да.
И переходим на контроль.
The next step is to bring the ring adapter down.
As you heard, Mir's free drift. We are. Thank you. Great picture.
Chris in the docking module.
We have an excellent picture.
Jerry's in there. They're finishing up the steps on, looks like, page 1-53.
We have a great picture.
У нас тоже все ты и тоже... А, вот, шоколад.
Да, потом, так сказать, и мы обменяемся, да?
А, спасибо, спасибо.
in Atlantis. This is Will Trafton representing NASA.
Это господин Трафтон представляет здесь НАСА. Он хотел бы обратиться к экипажу Атлантиса и к экипажу станции МИ.
My congratulations, of course, to Ken Cameron as the commander of Atlantis and to Cosmonaut Soloviev as the commander of Mir on a wonderful event here this morning in Moscow.
Я приношу поздравления командиру экипажа Атлантиса Кену Кэмерону со своей стороны и также командиру станции Мир Соловьеву. Поздравляю вас с успешной стыковкой. То, что мы наблюдали сегодня утром, было прекрасное событие.
You guys make the incredible look very, very easy. It was wonderful to watch.
То, что казалось нереальным, вы сделали вполне реальным. Это было замечательное зрелище.
And Ken, on behalf of NASA and in fact Chris Hadfield as well, on behalf of the Canadian Space Agency. A lot of folks are very, very proud of what you've done. I know you've worked hard to make this day happen, and we're proud of you. The NASA team is proud of you, and the Canadian team is proud of you.
Кен, я поздравляю вас от лица к группе НАСА, а также Крис, я поздравляю вас от Канадского космического агентства. И оба, и американское, и канадское агентство очень горды и счастливы вашей работы.
And Ken, you've come a long way from standing on the Soyuz pad with me in February of 1994 in the snow to being on board Mir today. It's wonderful to see you up there, and I know you feel good about it.
Кен, ты прошел очень длинный путь, начиная с февраля 94 года, когда мы стояли на ступеньках Союза, и сейчас вот вы на борту орбитальной станции Мир. Это был долгий, успешный путь.
Over to you, Ken.
Okay, thanks very much, Will. I certainly do appreciate all the work that has gone into making this flight possible. This is, for me, I think, a dream come true, and for all the crew, this is an honor and a privilege to be part of a program that will lead us all so far. I think you're right, coming from Baikonur to Mir,
the long way has certainly been an exciting voyage. Certainly, the crew of Mir gets to the station from Baikonur a lot quicker than it took me.
Для меня это был удивительный опыт. Спасибо большое, Уилл, я ценю ваши слова. Действительно, я прошел очень долгий путь от Байконура в 94 году, и сейчас вот я нахожусь на борту станции Мир. Для меня это очень большое событие. Спасибо большое.
I will sign off here. Congratulations again from the team. This is an important step in the building of an international space station, and we're very, very proud of you.
Спасибо большое, и мы поздравляем еще раз всю команду. Это первый очень серьезный такой вклад в будущее строительства Международной космической станции.
Дорогие космонавты, астронавты, я Юрий Осипов, президент Российской Академии Наук.
Dear cosmonauts and astronauts, here is speaking Yuri Osipov, the president of the Russian Academy of Sciences.
Мне доставляет громадное удовольствие передать вам слова приветствия от российских ученых.
I am delighted here to pass the words of greeting and welcome from the Russian scientists.
Мы восхищены вашей работой.
We are happy about the work you've done.
И вы сейчас демонстрируете всему миру.
Today you show to the whole world.
Каких выдающихся результатов может достичь человечество.
What wonderful results the mankind can reach.
Если оно опирается на волю.
If it's based on the will.
Труд.
Labor.
Научные и инженерные знания.
Scientific and engineering knowledge.
И особенно в тех условиях, когда наши страны объединяют свои усилия.
Especially under the conditions when both of our countries join our efforts.
Счастливого вам полета.
Good flight to you.
Большое спасибо за вот эти слова.
Thank you very much for your words.
Это правильно, что наша совместная работа будет являться прологом для дальнейших полезных работ, которые будут проводиться в скором времени, мы надеемся, на станции Альфа. И в ближайшем будущем также послужит для успешного продолжения дальнейших совместных полетов станции Мир и американских шаттлов.
Thank you very much for your good work. This is really the first step in our future cooperation in the International Space Station Alpha, and also on the future flights to Mir Station and the flights of American Shuttle.
Afternoon, Jim. Payloads is up.
Hey, Dave. We have transferred the five CWCs that have already been filled to the docking module. And I need some help on the return storage location for the two docking module centerline docking lines. What locker do they come home in?
Checking, Jim. Atlantis Mir, Chris, did you mean to give us permission to take downlink from the docking module?
Yeah, we're going to be in the docking module as a group. We got flags set up there, and then it'll be a short, and then we're going to break for